Hello, and a warm welcome to another video from Rosenberger OSI. Today I'm in our headquarters in the beautiful city of Augsburg, together with my colleague Harald Jungbäck, who has been working as a product manager in the data center market sector in our company for 30 years and is an expert in the field of optical fiber technology. Today I want to ask Harald what's going on with these MDC and SN connectors. Many customers are asking about this because these connectors are currently flooding onto the market. What is the situation? To answer that question, I'd like to show you something. At the top here, we have the MDC connector from the US Connect, and here is the SN connector from Senko. Both belong to the VSFF category, very small form factor connectors. I'll show you why they're here and what we need them for by means of another example. The starting point. The reason why these VSFF, MDC, and SN connectors were developed goes back a few years. Namely, optical transceivers. To transfer higher data rates than are possible using traditional duplex applications, you need parallelization. Conventionally, this has been done with transceivers that have an MTP-MPO connector face. Here, for example, there is an octo with 8 fibers over 4 lanes in parallel in order, for example, to achieve the current value of 400 gigabits, 100 gigabits per lane via conventional MTP-MPO plug connector. All of this is increasingly being done via transceivers like this one here with 4 MDC ports. Or alternatively, 4 SN ports. Why the difference? Why have these two designs? Why not carry on doing it like this? Why were the connectors here developed in order to build these transceivers like this? The reason is the port breakout. The port breakout directly from the transceiver. Here, if you want a point breakout, i.e., you want to tap the 4 individual ports, then you need a harness or cassette structure. Here, you can use individual patch cords to route the individual ports directly away from the transceiver for the port breakout. That is the main reason why these new, small MDC and SN connectors were developed. And here we are talking about a robust ceramic technology inside. 1.25mm ceramic ferrules coming from the MU and taken over by the LC. Together with all the advantages they bring. Robust, lower insertion loss, higher return loss than is possible with MTP-MPO technology. Harald, let's take a look at sustainability. How can this change of system help improve sustainability in data centers? Well, significantly. I think this is the greatest lever of all. Let's go back to our example and say that they are both 400 gigabit single mode 500 meter transceivers. 400G DR4 will become a very dominant protocol, and if I implement that with these QSFP DDs, then I only have 8 watts each. A consumption of 8 watts gives off correspondingly little heat. If alternatively I do that in the traditional way, as has been possible in the past, then I have 4 individual QSFP DD transceivers with 100G single mode and an LC duplex interface, i.e. I have 4 of them. Each of these has 4.5 watts, i.e. I have a total of 18 watts with correspondingly higher heat emissions compared to only 8 watts with this one or this one. So that is the great lever, the transceiver technology. Here there is less consumption, less emitted heat, and of course, the chassis, the switches, the servers, in which everything can be installed. It's logical that they need less space than the four, and the hardware itself is then more efficient, and that is a really large lever. That is the driver. Correspondingly, less electricity is needed in the data center, both for powering and for cooling. I understand. And then the connectors naturally make their contribution in the passive infrastructure due to their density. Let's take a look at our port density rack. Let's start here. The maximum possible today is four rows with LC duplex, or also with MTP. Of course, they are push-pull boot variants. They permit 96 ports per height unit. If we have LC duplex, then that is 96 duplex ports. That's it then, physically. If you use MTP, then you can imagine inserting a SEDKIM MTP here. Then you have 8 duplex ports per MTP. 96 of them naturally gives a huge number of duplex ports that I can have here. However, if I don't want to do that and stay with the duplex ceramic technology, then these new connectors, these VSFF, very small form factor connectors, make it possible to increase the port density in the panel, back again to 96 ports. Here, the classic 72 version with LC duplex. Then, with MDC and SN, we easily have 128 ports in the panel. Of course, it's all a bit dense and close together. You have to practice the patching a bit and rethink it a little, but it's manageable. It's doable. And so, that is their contribution to increased density. Less space rack is used, and so less space is needed, often in the valuable cooled area, and that of course helps save resources and increases the sustainability of data centers by achieving greater density in the passive infrastructure. Harald, many thanks for your explanations. If you have any questions on these issues, please get in touch with us. You can find our contact details on our website, and I'm looking forward to our next video. Thank you. And thank you from me as well.